before artificial insemination came and all that other stuff that came, the only way that you could produce was by sperm and seed. The seed ejected from the man directly into the womb. And you couldn't do that being in two different sides of the room. In order to produce and multiply, you had to be like this. You had to be intimate. John 15:4-7 talks about abiding in the vine. There's no fruitfulness and multiplication without abiding, without intimacy, without talking to God, without letting him talk to you, without abiding in his house, in his temple, without, there's no, we want multiplication, but we want to get pregnant by some other means. But God said, if you would just be intimate with me, if you would just come into me, if you would just come into my word, if you would just come and spend some time in prayer, if you would just come and spend some time sitting on my lap, if you would just come and spend some time not saying nothing, but just allowing me to put that seed in you that will be able to produce. And there, you know, we have to, there's no abiding without intimacy, and there's no intimacy without obedience. Okay? There's no abiding without intimacy, and there's no intimacy without obedience. Disobedience took the first family out. I'm talking about the first family of Eden. It took the first family out, and it's obedience that will keep you in. And the reason why a lot of us are not living up to our potential and not seeing our dreams realized is simply we've been disobedient in some area or not, and today is a day to repent. Today is a day of repentance. I was talking to my daughter the other day, and I told her I had spent 2 hours just praying and praying, and I got to the place where I just started repenting for anything, everything from childhood, just repenting with things that I know I have repented of, but just in case I didn't, I just began to repent. I just began to say things that I have never said to God before. I began to loose that thing from me. Hallelujah. And I know God has forgiven me, and so therefore he can work with that. He doesn't deal with disobedience. And sometimes we wake up and every day we're in disobedience. We're children of disobedience. We need our behind smack. And that's why we don't prosper. Hallelujah. Because God, the real Father, don't work like that. He doesn't bless disobedience. Bring forth fruit and that your fruit will remain. I don't want to just multiply. I don't want to just be fruitful, but I want my fruit to be good, and I want it to stay. We bought some strawberries just yesterday, and today I'm already looking at them, and some of them are already like going into spoil. And so we're not even going to be able to use those for like a whole week. We got to hurry up and eat them. But he said that he'll give us fruit that will remain. There'll be things that you produce that will become a legacy, that will become something that your children's children will be able to witness and say, you know, my mom and my daddy set that up. My mom and my daddy did that because the seed was sown in obedience, and the fruit that came forth, it prospered and it did not leave. Hallelujah. It did not leave. He just said, stay in me, children of God. Stay in me. Abide in me. Let my word abide in you, and then you can ask what you will, and it shall be done. Don't die. I don't care what the enemy is telling you. Don't give up. Don't despair. We don't die. We multiply. And sometimes you need to look at the enemy and say, is that all you got? Is that all you got to do? Because I've been hit with worse, and I'm still standing. I'm like that bouncer thing that you hit and goes back. The bump thing, and it comes back at you every time you hit it. It just keeps coming back. I'm just going to keep coming back. You're going to keep coming back. Don't die, y'all. Multiply. Amen. Stand on your feet.